गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
गुड आफ्टरनून, वेलकम टू दिस मॉक एग्जाम लाइक
यस सर।
एन ऑस्की पैटर्न। ओके, सो दिस इज अ न्यू सिस्टम लाइक इट हैज बीन एक्सप्लेन टू यू अर्लियर। सो वी आर विल गो थ्रू अ केस सिनेरियो। ओके, एंड एट ईच स्टेज विल आस्क यू फॉर योर इम्प्रेशन एंड फॉर योर थॉट्स ऑन दैट। ओके, सो कैन यू रीड दैट?
यस सर। 45-year-old जेंटलमैन कंप्लेन्स ऑफ वेक पेन इन द राइट हिप सिंस लास्ट 9 मंथ्स। द पेन वॉज इंसीडियस इन ऑनसेट एंड ग्रेजुअली प्रोग्रेसिव एंड करेंटली लिमिट्स हिज एक्टिविटी ऑफ डेली लिविंग। इट इज़ अ डल एकिंग पेन विथ नो रेडिएशन।
So with this history, what other details would you want to know?
Sir, I would like to know the if the pain is due to is mechanical or not, the pain is rest pain or not, if the pain aggravates in more, if the pain is more in the morning, or if the gentleman had a history of any trauma, and also the history of any childhood illness is to be known, sir.
Childhood condition, illness.
Childhood
okay.
conditions.
Right. Okay. So, right, it says there is no other joint involvement or no history of trauma. Any other details? Nothing in the?
No childhood illness and no history of blood transfusions.
Okay. Why would you think of repeated blood transfusions?
Sir, in case of sickle cell anemia, usually there is a lot of there is a history of blood transfusion, sir, which can lead to there is no family history also, sir.
Right. So with these points in
and there is no significant drug intake history.
What sort of drug intake are you concerned about?
Sir, I am concerned about the history of taking corticosteroids for a long duration. So.
Why are you concerned about what's wrong with corticosteroids if you take for too long? What can happen?
Sir, it can lead to a vascular necrosis of the femoral head, sir.
Okay. Any other drugs or only corticosteroids are available? He's a young man with dull aching pain, restriction of activities. Any other conditions that you can think of?
Sir, I will also like to rule out tuberculosis, Cox, any history of Cox. For that also, I will take the drug history, sir.
So there again, family history is also relevant. Yeah, contact history is relevant.
Yes, sir.
And also, whether he's been on any medication. Fine. So, with this history, with these points in the history, what can be your thought process about the possible diagnosis?
Sir, my possible diagnosis will be an osteoarthritis of the right hip, sir, which may be due to secondary to a vascular necrosis of the femoral head, sir.
Okay, so to say osteoarthrosis, what are all the points? Is it just in the history that you can make out, or you need to correlate that with your clinical findings as well?
I will also see clinical findings, sir.
Yeah, okay. So, just by this history, it's difficult to say that it is arthritis, isn't it?
We'll also give a differential of tuberculosis also, sir, in spite of any drug histories.
Okay. So, what's the cardinal clinical finding in osteoarthritis?
Sir, mechanical pain, sir.
No, no. Not just in the history, in the physical findings. Maybe we can come to that later. Okay, so here's a video. Can you describe that gait?
So this gait, the patient is walking bipedal, unassisted, with head central. The shoulder is dipping to the right side.
Dipping, yeah.
Dipping to the right side. The pelvis is dipping to the right side. It is with equal stance and
is
swing.
Is it equal? Have a look again.
Decrease in the stance in the right side, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So,
what so this is a this is an antalgic gait, sir.
Okay. On only antalgic or
with some short limb component is also
okay. So that's fine. Now coming to the examination, can you read what's given there?
On inspection, the right patella and the medial malleoli is at a higher level. There is an exaggerated lumbar lordosis. Right anterior superilex spine is at a higher level. On palpation, there is a tenderness in the anterior joint line and greater trochanter is at a higher level.
Okay.
On movements, the right hip flexion is 0 to 110 degree and left hip is 0 to 120 degree. Extension is not possible. And extension on the left hip is 0 to 10 degree, adduction of 20 to 40 degrees, and abduction on the left side is 0 to 30 degrees, internal rotation 0 to 10 degrees extension in knee extension, internal rotation 0 to 30 degree in knee flexion, and external rotation 0 to 40 degree in both knees flexion and extension.
So what does this tell you, the finding, what does it suggest to you?
So there is an increased internal rotation on knee flexion, but on knee extension the internal rotation is decreased. So this gives an indication of differential rotation.
Okay, that's good. Apart from that, anything else?
There is
overall range of movement.
There is also the adduction is 20 to 40 degrees on the right side, sir.
Mm-hmm.
So there is no abduction possible. So there is an adduction deformity is also there. And flexion is okay, sir.
So he's got a good range of flexion, right?
Yes, sir.
So there is, what do you call this? There is the ROM universally restricted or?
Terminally, the ROM is, range of motion is restricted.
Selective restriction of range of movement, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So essentially, what is restricted here?
The abduction is absent in the right side, sir.
Abduction and?
Extension, sir.
Extension, okay.
The internal rotation, sir, yeah, is decreased.
Compared to the other side, abduction and internal rotation. Yeah.
On examination measurements, there is an apparent shortening of 2 cm. There is a true shortening of 1 cm. The Bryant's base is reduced by 1 cm as compared to the opposite side. And there is a wasting of the right thigh muscle of 1 cm.
Okay.
Yes, sir. On Thomas test, there is no fixed flexion deformity. Telescopy test is negative. Trendelenburg test is not carried out. Nilotin's line, a greater trochanter is proximal to the line. Shoemaker's line meets on the opposite side below the umbilicus.
So what does that suggest to you?
So telescopy, Thomas test could not be done because there was a coronal deformity.
Thomas test or Trendelenburg test?
Trendelenburg test, sorry.
Mm-hmm.
And since the telescopy, there is nothing wrong with the head and neck, so telescopy is negative. The Nilotin's line shows supratrochanteric migration is there, sir. Shortening is there, so greater trochanter has moved up.
What do you mean by there is nothing wrong with the head and neck? So why will the patient come to you with a limp? Is giving you a history of pain.
There is no discontinuity between the...
Yeah, that's the right word to use. Okay, so that's what you got to say, right?
Yes, sir. Okay. Shoemaker's line also shows that it is supratrochanteric shortening is there.
Anything else?
No, sir.
So, can you summarize from the history, the physical findings, what has been briefly told?
A 45-year-old gentleman had a history of vague hip pain,
mm-hmm,
which was gradually progressive, and it has limited his activities of daily living. There is no history of any childhood illness or any history of trauma, no history of any addiction. On examination...
Addiction or drug intake?
Drug intake.
Yeah, okay.
And on examination, there is both the... superilex spine was at the same level, sir.
It was slightly higher, I think.
Right side was higher,
yeah.
And there was an exaggerated lumbar lordosis.
Yeah.
There was anterior joint line tenderness was there, and there was the on the right side there was an no abduction and extension, and there was differential internal rotation deformity was there.
So there was selective restriction of movements with a good flexion with so-called, what is that sign called when the rotation, internal rotation is more in extension and less in flexion?
Sectorial sign, sir.
Sectorial sign. Where do you see that?
Sir, I will see that when the head is deformed or flattened in the anterolateral aspect, especially, sir.